So for the code that you just saw, you started with this probability space given by sunny, rainy, snowy with probabilities half, one sixth, one third. You sampled from this probability space to get a random outcome, which mathematically will usually denote with little omega. Okay, so we had a little omega sampled from this probability space above. And then we had a random variable w, which is set equal to omega. Okay, and this is true for omega being any of the possible outcomes, sunny, rainy, snowy. On the other hand, I was one if omega was sunny, and zero if omega was either rainy or snowy. So if omega was in the event rainy, snowy. Okay, in fact, for the first case, we can write that in terms of an event as well. We have omega within the set consisting of a single element, sunny. Okay. Note that W and I are functions of little omega. Okay. W maps from the sample space to, well, actually it maps it to the sample space again, whereas I maps from the sample space to 0, 1. Okay. In general, how we're going to define a random variable is that first we're going to have an associated probability space, okay, much like how we had an associated probability space up there. So in general, given a probability space, omega p, random variable x is going to be a function that maps from omega, the sample space, to some alphabet, which we'll denote by script x. Okay? Here, this is the sample space, and here, this is the what we're calling the alphabet, and we'll also call this the set of values that random variable x takes on. Okay, back to our previous example, w takes on values in the alphabet, which is just the sample space, sunny, rainy, snowy, whereas I took on values in the set, so is equal to 0, 1. Okay, this is basically these are the alphabets for these random variables. Okay, a different way to view this is that we started off with this probability space, and we can view W also in terms of this table representation. So W, actually, I mean, the table representation for W looks the same. Okay, so I'm just gonna make a copy of this. So W looks the same. Whereas I, basically, what I says is I'm going to relabel sunny to be 1, and I'm going to relabel rainy to be 0, and snowy to be 0. Okay? Of course, if you look at this, you go like, well, I have two rows that are both with label 0. Why don't I just combine them? So I add 1/6 and 1/3 to get 1/2. And so the table I would get would be I has just 1 and 0 for the rows, and the probability is just half, half. Okay? Note that a random variable, then, you can view as you have a probability space, and then you get to possibly relabel what the outcomes are. Of course, you can, in the case of W, we chose not to relabel them, But for a random variable in general, you can relabel what the rows are. Okay?